إن الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله Now book Bulugh Eng Prayer were in the hadith 255 second part of that hadith We mention the times of the istighfar We say بعد الصلوات and we said في الحج and we mention بعد المجالس when we see someone somewhere gathering after that Number four, thuluthul laylil akhir, the last one-third of the night. The last one-third of the night. Hadith mutafiqun alayhi, an Abi Hurayra radiallahu anhu, anna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala, yanzilu Rabbuna tabarak wa ta'ala. Allah descends. Descending of Allah means where's Allah? Up. So he comes down. It's wrong belief to say Allah is in everywhere. It's wrong belief to say Allah is in everywhere. Allah is above the arsh. Istawa al arsh. Allah rose over his throne. That's the belief of Ahlul Sunnah. That's the belief of the Prophet. That's the belief of commandments. When Rasulullah wanted or wished to tear the Kaaba from, to tear the Qibla from Qudus to the Kaaba in Mecca. Used to raise his eyes up to Allah. قَدْ نَرَى تَقَلُّبَ وَجْهِكَ فِي السَّمَاءِ So why is he looking up? Where's Allah? You can't look under your shoes, under your feet, to look for Allah. So Allah istawa ala arsh. If you believe other than that, you are in danger. So Allah descends. كل ليلة إلى سماء الدنيا. Every night, Allah comes down to the nearest heaven to us. حين يبقى ثلث الليل الآخر. When we reach the last one third of the night. Use your logic. As Akhwan Muslimin and Sufis they do. In last one third of the night, it starts. Yeah, in cascade, every minute it starts in a new place, isn't it? Yes, the world is, the earth is moving, so every, through the lane, it happens in every second, everywhere, as the earth moves. So can you want to imagine that Allah is frequently up and down? Don't use your logic. Don't use your logic. As a believer, you should believe. Prophet said, when the sun sets, when the sun sets, it goes to the arsh and then sujood, and Allah commands it to rise from the east. Can't the science prove the sun does sujood? No, they can't. They can't prove. Prophet told us, Gog and Magog, they exist now. What the science didn't discover? There's something called belief, aqida. Yeah. Science, that's the word. Science is not belief, science. Google Map. Google Map, why they don't find it? Where they live? Google Map. If you put your belief on the science, you're going to be out of the Islam. You're going to be out of the Islam. Yeah. Belief unseen. camera did they use? They can't see the shaitan, they can't see the angels, they can't see Allah. Can they? Someone dying, put camera next to him. You can't see the soul leaving it. So don't be like Ahwan, want to prove the Islam through the science. Through the science, don't prove the Islam is right. No, that's not your job. Your job is to believe Allah and Rasuluh. Yes. Your job is to believe Allah and Rasuluh and accept that. Regardless of what others do or say. Otherwise you are weak iman, you are wobbling. When a weak iman, someone push you with finger, you fall to the kufr, finish. So you be strong iman. You believe what Allah and His Messenger told us. There's adab al-qabr. Also some Muslims they deny. Some call Muslims they deny adab al-qabr. There's adab al-qabr. Put the deceased in the grave and put camera next to them. Can't you see anything? No. And Prophet told us that angels, Munkar and Nakir, they are coming. They are pulling the person to sit up and they question the person. So don't put your belief in danger. Yeah. If when it comes to contradicting between science and religion, drop the science. Drop the view. Drop the logic away. Take what you believe and has been authorized from Allah and His Messenger. That is your job. So last one third of the night, يقول, Allah says, so Allah speaks. Yeah. Prophet didn't say, the tree will say on behalf of Allah, or the angel will say on behalf of Allah, no. يقول, Allah says. So Allah speaks. Allah said in the Quran, وَكَلَّمَ اللَّهُ مُوسَى. Allah spoke to Musa. Al-Jahmiyyah, Sufis, they said, no, it means وَكَلَّمَ اللَّهُ. Musa spoke to Allah. It doesn't mean Allah spoke to Musa. So what happened at the Jabal Tur? Jabal Tur, what happened in that case? Yeah. Jabal Tur. At Jabal Tur, they say, Allah spoke to Allah showed himself to a tree, and tree spoke to Musa. What's that khulafa? Who said that? Who said that there was a tree and tree spoke to Musa? Al-Jahmiyyah. One of the sects. Al-Jahmiyyah are the Sufis of today. All the Sufis today, they belong to Jahmiyyah. And all these fighting and bombing and killing Muslims, they are Khawarij. That two groups are today main two groups in the Islam. So if you know Khawarij and Jahmiyyah, you'll be saving your religion. You should study the science of Khawarij and Al-Jahmiyyah, Al-Murji'ah. Allah said, Man yad'uni, who make dua? فَأَسْتَجِيبَ لَهُ. This fa, it's called fa'u ta'qib. Immediately I will accept this dua. Immediately I will accept his dua. When yas'aluni, who asks me anything, فَأُعْدِيَهُ, and I will guarantee that what he asks for him. فَأُوْ تَعْقِيبُ. It doesn't need to waste time. ما من يستغفرني, whoever asks me forgiveness, فأغفر له, and I will forgive him. So that one, the last one third of the night, is the time you ask Allah's forgiveness. You seek Allah's forgiveness. So that's the most important times for our istighfar. You say بعد الصلوات في الحج بعد المجالس عام ثلث الليل الأخير. That's most important times to ask Allah forgiveness. But can we ask Allah forgiveness any other time? First of all, say the istighfar. The dua, which is the master or the chief of highest of istighfar. You learn that dua, you use at the Maghrib time and Fajr time. عن شداد بن أوس حدثنا رجل البخاري عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال سيد الاستغفار, the highest of the استغفار, the person can do, أن تقول to say اللهم أنت ربي. This is a clarification. You don't have any other Lord. You don't have any other Lord. Allah is only and only my Lord. La ilaha illa ant. I'm not worshiping anyone beside you. If you go to the grave, you are worshiping the grave with Allah. We don't ask that grave. Go to the grave of so and so and ask him something that you are worshiping with him, Allah. You think the awliya can come and support you and help you from the grave, you are worshiping them with Allah. You prefer to do your overtime, not to pray. Yeah, you worship Allah with your desire, with your job. You're committing shirk. Say something simple. Yeah. Say, no, no, salah, I will do it when I go home. But most important is the job. I'm feeding my family. That means, you are not taking commands from Allah. You are taking commands from your desire. You didn't fulfill إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ. And you say, خَلَقْتَنِي وَأَنَا عَبْدُكَ. Oh Allah, you are the one who created me. Who created you? Allah. Not science, not your parents. Yeah. Your parents didn't create you. Just they were heated up. Yes. They want to relieve themselves. But when Allah created you, Allah is the one who decides when he should create you. Not your parents. So you believe, wa ana abduka, oh Allah, I am your slave. If someone else creates you, be slave of that person. But who created you? Allah and Allah only. Wa ana ala ahdika, I am at your covenant. Yeah, promise. Wa wa'dika, you promise Master Ta'at as far as I can. So yourself, you are miskin. You can't do sin. That's not the problem. You can do sin. If you don't do sin, you'll be angel. You'll be a malaika if you don't do sin. You're committing sin. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, كل ابن آدم خطاء. Every single child of Adam committing sin, way or other. Major or minor or mistake. So we are not safe from that point. No. So in here, you say in your dua, أَعُوذِ بِكَ مِنْ شَرِّ مَا صَنَعَتُ. O Allah, I seek refuge in you from the mistakes and mischiefs and evils which I have done. Which I have done. So how you can come back from that mischief? Prophet said, كُلُّ بِنِ آدَمَ خَطَّى وَخَيْرُ الْخَطَّائِينَ. The best of those who commit sin or mistakes are at-tawwabun. Yes, those who repent. So you should repent always. A'udhu bika min sharri ma sana'tu. That's repentance. Abu laka bi ni'matika alayya. Yeah. Abu laka, I'm acknowledged. Ni'matika bi ni'matika, you favor alayya upon me. The ni'mah you gave me. What a ni'mah Allah gave you? Can you count? Number one, health. You have eye. If Allah take your eye out, away, no one can give you back your eye. You hear. Yeah. Your organs, which are running 24 hours and you don't know. Your heart, your liver, your kidney, your blood circulation, 24 hours. You don't have any command to them. All that. But Allah gave you one major favorite. What Allah favor you? Islam. What's the meaning of Islam? Means after I die, I will live a good life. So Allah saved me. To be a Muslim means, Allah saves you from the punishment, and from the grieving, and from the wailing, and from the crying in the hellfire. That's the best ni'mah Allah gave you. Sometimes you don't feel that. You're born in a Muslim society, Muslim community, you're born in Islam, you don't feel the meaning, you don't feel the value of Islam. But Allah gave you a big Muslim, that's big favor. Yeah. Even if you are a wrong person, even if you do sin, whatever you do it, even if you go to hellfire, you end up to paradise. Eternal, forever. Yeah. Life, al-khuld. Yeah, will never end. So that's the favor. Alhamdulillah ala al-Islam. Alhamdulillah ala al-Islam. Wa abu bidambi, I acknowledge also and confess my sin. So what I want, اغفر لي Allah, oh Allah forgive me. فَنُوا لَا يَغْفِرُ الدُّنُوبِ إِلَّا أَنْتَ. No one can forgive the sins except you, oh Allah. So look what Prophet says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. مَنْ قَالَهَا مِنَ النَّهَارِ. Whoever says on the daytime, مُوقِنًا بِهَا, a firm belief. مُوقِن means strongly you believe that will happen. فَمَاتَ مِيَوْمِهِ. When you're going to die. Do you know when you're going to die? Yes. So that means, every day you should do that dua. If it comes and you die that day, what's happening? فَمَاتَ مِنْ يَوْمِهِ قَبْلَ أَنْ يَمْسِي أَنْ يُمْسِي. And you die that day after you said at the Fajr time that dua, and you die that day, فَهُوَ مِنْ أَهَلِ الْجَنَّةِ. He's one of the dwellers of the paradise. So if you don't know when you are going to die, it's right for you today to say it every day, every morning to say it. Maybe it can like it by the day of your death. How about the night? وَمَنْ قَالَهَا مِنَ اللَّيْلِ Whoever says that dua in the night, وَهُوَ مُوقِنٌ بِهَا yeah. And he believe, affirm, strongly believe that dua. فَمَاتَ قَبْلَ أَنْ يُسْبِحَ And the person dies before dawn, before morning. فَهُوَ مِنْ أَهْلِ جَنَّةٍ So that dua, strongly, yeah. He put it in our Fajr and Mesa to us, yeah, we collect it. That's very important. Rabi'an, number four, istighfar Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu used to do istighfar. We see that inshallah in our lesson, our next lesson. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك اشهد ان لا اله الا انت استغفرك واتوب اليك وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا وعلى اله وصحبه ومن تبعهم باحسان الى يوم الدين